The lion and the mouse, the lion and the mouse. This is the story of the lion and the mouse.
Mouse was creeping through the woods and woke a sleeping lion. Angrily he grabbed that mouse. She was scared and crying. She said,
"If you let me go, I'll help you someday. Soon you'll see. When you need me, I'll be there. You'll count on me."
The lion and the mouse, the lion and the mouse. This is the story of the lion and the mouse. The lion and the mouse, the lion and the mouse. This is the story of the lion and the mouse.
Lion said,
"You tiny thing, what could you do for me? Tell you what, ha ha, you made me laugh, so I will set you free."
"Thank you."
Next day, Lion stalked his prey, but on his way back home, he walked into a trap. He was captured and alone.
The lion and the mouse, the lion and the mouse. Of the lion and the mouse. The lion and the mouse. The lion and the mouse. This is the story of the lion and the mouse.
Tiny mouse heard lion's roar and scurried to the scene. She gnawed the rope, released the lion and said,
"Now we're a team."
Lion answered,
"I was wrong to laugh because you're small. If it weren't for you, I would not be here at all."
The lion and the mouse, the lion and the mouse. Best friends forever, the lion and the mouse. The lion and the mouse, the lion and the mouse. Best friends forever, the lion and the mouse. The lion and the mouse, the lion and the mouse. This is the story of the lion and the mouse.
Once upon a time, there were three billy goats. They went across a river, but hadn't any boats.
"Look over there, there's a bridge, can you see? We'll cross to the hills where the grass grows free."
Meh, 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 meh.
The little billy goat, he first began to cross. Trip, trap, trip, trap, the bridge made a noise.
"Who's that tripping over my bridge?"
said a troll from below and came up close.
Meh, 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 meh.
"I'm going to gobble you,"
said the troll of the river. Little goat said, "I'm tiny, my brother's much bigger.
Wait a little bit, he's going to come through."
The troll said,
"Hmm, be off with you."
Second billy goat, he began to cross. Trip, trap, trip, trap, the bridge made a noise.
"Who's that tripping over my bridge?"
said the troll from below and came up close.
Meh, 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 meh.
"I'm going to gobble you,"
said the troll of the river.
The goat said, "I'm small, my brother's much bigger. Wait a little bit, he's going to come through."
The troll said,
"Hmm, be off with you."
Meh, 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 meh.
The big billy goat then began to cross. Trip, trap, trip, trap, the bridge made a noise.
"Who's that tripping over my bridge?"
said a troll from below and came up close.
"I'm going to gobble you,"
said the troll to the goat. The goat stared at him. him made a noise with his throat. He charged with his horns and knocked the troll down. The three billy goats lived happily then.
With a bundle of straw, three little pigs sang law, law, law. One built a house with a bundle of straw. A wolf came along and began knocking.
Knock, 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 knock.
Little pig, let me come in.
No, no, by the hair of my chinny chin chin.
Then I'll hop and I'll puff and I'll blow your house in.
Huff!
Little pigs were in a fix. One built a house with a bundle of sticks.
Two little pigs were in a fix. One built a house with a bundle of sticks.
A wolf came along and began knocking.
Knock, 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 knock.
Little pig, let me come in.
No, no, by the hair of my chinny chin chin.
Then I'll hop and I'll puff and I'll blow your house in.
Puff, puff, puff.
One little pig screamed quick, quick, quick. He built his house with a load of bricks.
One little pig screamed quick, quick, quick. He built his house with a load of bricks.
A wolf came along and began knocking.
Knock, 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 knock.
Little pig, let me come in.
No, no, by the hair of my chinny chin chin.
Then I'll hop and I'll puff and I'll blow your house in.
Huff, puff, puff.
But he could not blow the house down, and the three little pigs lived happily in the brick house.
Bears in the house in the forest. Papa Bear, Mama Bear, Baby Bear sat down to eat their porridge.
Much too hot.
Proud Papa Bear, let's go and walk in the forest. That's when Goldilocks came by, found their house in the thicket. Knock, 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 no answer, so Goldie entered the kitchen.
Smells good.
She grabbed a spoon, though she had no permission.
Papa Bear's porridge, way too hot.
Mama Bear's porridge, way too cold.
Baby Bear's porridge, just right, just right, just right.
After Goldie had her fill, she felt lazy and tired. In the living room she spied chairs of three different sizes. They look quite inviting, so Goldie thought she'd try 'em. Papa Bear's chair, way too hard.
Mama Bear's chair, way too soft.
Baby Bear's chair, just right, just right, just right.
Just as Goldie settled in, that chair broke into pieces. Goldie went upstairs and found three nice beds she could sleep in. They looked quite inviting, so Papa's bed she creeped in.
Papa Bear's bed, way too hard.
Mama Bear's bed, way too soft.
Baby Bear's bed, just right, just
eating my porridge.
Growled Papa, someone's been eating my porridge.
Said Mama,
someone's been eating my porridge.
Cried Baby,
and they ate it all up, ate it all up.
They walked into the living room, and what do you think they noticed?
Someone's been sitting in my chair.
Growled Papa,
someone's been sitting in my chair.
Said Mama,
someone's been sitting in my chair.
Cried Baby,
and they've broken it up, broken it up.
Upstairs in their bedroom now, what do you think they noticed?
Someone's been sleeping in my bed.
Growled Papa,
someone's been sleeping in my bed.
Said Mama,
someone's been sleeping in my bed.
Cried Baby,
and there she is, there she is.
Goldilocks woke up and saw three brown bears staring at her. She screamed,
help!
Jumped out of bed and ran away with a clatter. Down the stairs and through the door, their heads, fixed the chair and made the beds, and sat down to eat their porridge. And that is the story of the three bears.
Sad.
I really
she opened them, she was by the riverside. She shook her head, looked at the stream.
I just had the strangest dream. Was that all just a dream?
Story about the boy who cried wolf? No, tell me.
The boy who cried wolf. The boy who cried wolf.
There was a boy who watched the sheep. He'd watch him walk and watch him sleep. He was so bored he made a plan.
I need to find some action, man.
Telling the truth, Mark.
Yep. No more crying wolf for this boy.
Ready for story time, little twins?
Yay!
How about Jack and the Beanstalk?
You need to go to town to sell our favorite cow. So Jack took their cow in his hands. He walked to town and met a man.
I've got a deal for a boy like you. You can buy my magic beans.
Magic beans? What do they do?
You plant them and they'll grow so huge. Plant them in the ground, and overnight, they'll grow all the way up to the sky.
So Jack sold the cow to the man, who put the beans in his hand. When he went home to show his mom, she was very mad.
What shall we do? What shall we do?
So tall and green, it went all the way up to the sky.
This is a stalk I have to climb.
He climbed and he climbed and climbed some more. Through the clouds, he saw a door.
Look at that castle, so very big. I wonder who lives inside that thing.
Then the door opened.
Something to eat.
She cooked some breakfast for the boy, but at the door there was a giant noise.
3, 5, 4, boy, I smell a little boy. I smell a little boy.
Jack got scared and ran away. He grabbed the golden egg on his way. He climbed back down the green beanstalk and gave the egg to his mom. The very next day, he climbed to the sky. He found a golden harp in the castle of high.
3, 5, 4, boy, I smell a little boy.
Jack got scared and ran away, but the giant chased him all the way. He climbed down the beanstalk really fast and chop, chop, chopped it down. Now Jack and his mom had so much gold, they were rich until they were old. They both lived happily ever after. Happily ever after.
Jack and the Beanstalk. Yeah, yeah, yeah. The end.
Yay.
Hey, do you guys know the story of Little Red Riding Hood?
Sure we do, and it's my favorite.
Once upon a time in the woods, there lived a little girl, Red Riding Hood. Had to visit Grandma, sick in bed. So off she went with a basket of bread.
Do you do? Where are
visit Grandma far away. You can't come. Now I'll be on my way.
But Wolf had a plan, and off he ran to Grandma's house on the other side of the woods.
Wolfie arrived at Grandma's house, crept through the door like a little mouse.
Grandma saw the wolf, then she screamed and ran into the closet so she couldn't be seen.
I will wait just right here for Little Red Riding Hood to appear.
Wolf put on dear Grandma's clothes, her lovely night dress, and glasses on his nose.
What a clever wolf I am to pretend that I am dear Grandma, sick in bed.
I hope Red Riding Hood gets here fast and rescues me. This wolf is bad.
Just then, Red Riding Hood arrived at Grandma's house. She opened the door and walked right up to her grandma's bed.
Grandma, I am here, poor thing in bed. I brought you some yummy bread.
Thank you, dear. I'm feeling sick. Come a little closer. Take a look.
Grandma, you don't seem yourself. What can I do to help?
I must have a nasty bug. Climb on the bed and give me a hug.
Grandma, what big eyes you have.
Big eyes to see you.
Grandma, what big ears you have.
Big ears to hear you.
Grandma, what big teeth you have.
Big teeth to eat you.
Poor Little Red Riding Hood. Thankfully, a lumberjack was passing by and heard her cry. He broke down the door and came inside.
What's going on? Are you okay? I heard you scream from far away. Hey, big bad wolf, get out of here. And don't you come.
The story of the lion and the mouse.
Yeah!
The lion and the mouse. The lion and the mouse. The lion and the mouse. Yeah! The lion and the mouse.
One day, there was a mouse walking through the woods. She came across.
What are you doing in my neighborhood?
The lion grabbed the little mouse, held her up high.
Please, sir, let me go.
Let you go? Tell me why.
If you let me go gently, I'll help you one day, you'll see.
The lion laughed.
You think you can help me? You're a silly, billy, tiny little mouse. Okay, I'll set you free.
Wow, you sure are brave.
Yeah! The next day, the lion
Oh, help me. Won't somebody help me?
The lion and the mouse. The lion and the mouse.
The mouse heard a lion's roar and knew just what to do. She called her friends. They ran to the lion.
Grab the rope and start to chew.
Wow, you saved me. Even though you're small, I should never have laughed at you at all.
Okay, twins, it's story time.
How about the story of Goldilocks and the Three Bears?
Yay!
Once upon a time, in a house in the forest, there lived three bears who loved their porridge. They ate it every morning and every night. Papa's was hot, Mama's was cold. Baby's just right.
I'm Papa Bear, I'm big and proud.
I'm Mama Bear, I could roar so loud.
I'm Baby Bear, this is my chair.
And we're the Three Bears.
The Three Bears decided to go get some honey to put on their porridge. So off they went into the woods.
Right across the woods lived a little girl with golden hair and lots of curls. Everybody called her Goldilocks. Off she goes.
Off I go.
Into the woods.
Oh, look, I found a little house. I'll knock, knock on the door. No one's home. Well, that's okay.
And in she went. Anyway. Little did Goldilocks know, she had just entered the house of the Three Bears.
Wow, look over there, a table of food. Great, 'cause I am in the mood for a big bowl of porridge just for me. Hey, there's one! Wait, there's two! No, look, there's three!
Papa Bear's porridge?
That's too hot!
Mama Bear's porridge?
That's too cold!
Baby Bear's porridge.
Just right.
After Goldilocks had eaten her fill of porridge, she was feeling full and wanted to rest her feet. Papa Bear's chair looked
much too hard.
Mama Bear's chair looked
much too soft.
Baby Bear's chair was the final one. Goldie was too heavy for Baby Bear's chair, and so it broke!
Oops!
Now she was feeling really sleepy, so decided to go upstairs to lay down her golden head.
Papa Bear's bed looked
much too hard.
Mama Bear's bed looked
much too soft.
Baby Bear's bed was the final one.
Let's see. Oh, wowee! This one's just right.
Just as Goldie fell asleep, the three bears returned home to discover they were not alone.
Someone's been eating Papa Bear's porridge.
Someone's been eating Mama Bear's porridge.
Someone's been eating babies too.
Let's see. Oh, dearie me! They ate it! All up!
Someone's been sifting in Papa Bear's chair.
Someone's been sifting in Mama Bear's chair.
Were not very happy at all. They went upstairs to find the intruder.
Someone's been sleeping in Papa Bear's bed.
Someone's been sleeping in Mama Bear's bed.
Someone's been sleeping in babies too.
Let's see. Oh, dearie me. There she is.
Who are you?
Bears! You ate my porridge! You broke my chair! You slept in my bed!
Goldilocks realized she wasn't a welcome guest, and the three bears chased her right out of their house.
She ran all the way home and never returned. A very good lesson she had learned. Again, the bears' home was filled with laughter, and they lived happily ever after. The end.
And Billy the Biggie.
The Billy Goat's Gruff.
Billy the Biggie, the Billy Goat's Gruff.
They ate and ate the grass all day until it all was gone. They ate all the clover
till none was left over.
They were lawn mowers, those Billy Goat's Gruff.
They were lawn mowers, those Billy Goat's Gruff.
But over a river and over a bridge was a hillside covered with grass. Green and delicious.
And rich and nutritious.
It answered their wishes, that yummy fresh grass.
It answered their wishes, that yummy fresh grass.
Billy the Little ran down to the river and onto the bridge he hopped. Clippity-cloppity, hippity-hoppity. Up jumped a troll and he hollered out,
"Stop!"
Up jumped a troll and he hollered out, "Stop!"
"Who are you?"
said the troll.
"I'm Billy the Little Goat Gruff.
Before I get thinner, I'll eat you for dinner."
Would this be the end for this Billy Goat Gruff?
Would this be the end for this Billy Goat Gruff?
"Oh, please, Mr. Troll, I'm very small, and you look very hungry. Billy the Middle Goat Gruff is coming next, and he's much bigger and tastier than I am."
"Well, all right then. Be off with you. I'll wait for Billy the Middle Goat Gruff."
Billy the Middle ran down to the river and onto the bridge he hopped. Clippity-cloppity, hippity-hoppity, up jumped the troll and he hollered out,
"Stop!"
Up jumped the troll and he hollered out, "Stop!"
"Who are you?"
said the troll.
"I'm Billy the Middle Goat Gruff.
Before I get thinner, I'll eat you for dinner."
Would this be the end for this Billy Goat Gruff?
Would this be the end for this Billy Goat Gruff?
"Oh, please, Mr. Troll, I'm not very big, and you look very hungry. Billy the Biggie Goat Gruff is coming next, and he's much bigger and tastier than I am."
"Well, all right then. Be off with you. I'll wait for Billy the Biggie Goat Gruff."
Billy the Biggie ran down to the river and onto the bridge he hopped. Clippity-cloppity, hippity-hoppity, up jumped the troll and he hollered out,
"Stop!"
Up jumped the troll and he hollered out, "Stop!"
"Who are you?"
said the troll.
"I'm Billy the Biggie Goat Gruff.
Before I get thinner, I'll eat you for dinner."
Would this be the end for this Billy Goat Gruff?
Would this be the end for this Billy Goat Gruff?
Oh, yeah?
Billy the Biggie, he lowered his horns and charged straight at the troll. And over hill, over glen, and over the mountain, that bad troll flew.
Over the mountain, that bad troll flew.
And happily ever after lived upon that grassy bluff.
Billy the Little.
And Billy the Middle.
And Billy the Biggie.
The Billy Goat's Gruff.
And Billy the Biggie, the Billy Goat's Gruff.
Oh my, I asked Huggy and Buggy to tidy their room before going out to play.
Those kids.
Do you know where they are?
I think I saw them in the backyard. I'll go find them, Jen.
Wow, it's so cool to look at all the little insects. Yeah, the ants are my favorite.
My favorite is the grasshopper.
That reminds me of a story. And I think this might be a good time to tell it to you.
The ants go plowing in the field.
Hi-ho, hi-ho.
The ants go plowing in the field.
Hi-ho, hi-ho.
The ants go plowing in the field.
The grasshoppers do cartwheels.
And all they do is play while the ants work all day. Digging in the sun.
Hi-ho, hi-ho.
The ants go digging in the sun.
Hi-ho, hi-ho.
The ants go digging in the sun.
The grasshoppers dance for fun.
And all they do is play while the ants work all day. Grasshoppers are cold and sad.
Oh no! Oh no!
The grasshoppers are cold and sad.
Oh no! Oh no!
They never helped, they wished they had.
And now they feel really bad.
All they did was play while the ants worked all day.
The ants invite them to come in.
Hi ho! Hi ho!
The ants invite them to come in.
Hi-ho, hi-ho.
The grasshopper said with a grin,
"We'll never shirk our work again."
And the ants all shout, "Hooray!
Hooray! Hooray!
Hooray!
Hooray!
Hooray!"
fo-fum. I smell a boy, by gosh, by gum.
That bad chime, he boomed and boomed, and Jack went flying out of that room.
Back the way he come, he come. Back the way he come.
After Jack the giant chased, he chased Jack all over the place when suddenly,
hip hip hooray,
came Gigi and Noah to save the day. They froze that giant like stone, like stone.
They froze that giant like stone.
To the beanstalk, Jack ran fast and bold, and there he found
a sack of gold.
His mama's gold that giant stole so many, many years ago. Down the stalk,
Jack flew, Jack flew. Down the stalk, Jack flew.
He grabbed an axe when he hit the ground.
Chop, chop, chop!
That stalk came down.
Mama, we're rich!
To his mama he told, and Jack gave his mama
the sack of gold.
Happily ever after
they lived, they lived.
Happily ever after
they lived.
Of the three little pigs, the three little pigs, the three little pigs. This is the story of the three little pigs. Once upon a time, the three little pigs had three little homes, all in a row, all in a row. The three little pigs had three little homes. Once upon a time, said the policeman.
You can't do that. No, 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 no.
And that was the story of the three little pigs. The three little pigs. The three little pigs. And that was the story of the three little pigs. Once upon a time.
Once upon a time.
Silly pigs.
Once there lived three grizzly bears in a house in the forest. Papa Bear, Mama Bear, Baby Bear sat down to eat their porridge.
Ooh, much too hot!
Growled Papa Bear, let's go walk in the forest. That's when Goldilocks came by, found their house in the thicket. Knock, 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 no answer, so Goldie entered the kitchen.
Mmm, smells good.
She grabbed a spoon, though she had no permission.
Papa Bear's porridge, way too hot.
Mama Bear's porridge, way too cold.
Baby Bear's porridge, just right, just right.
After Goldie had her fill, she felt lazy and tired. In the living room she spied chairs of three different sizes. They looked quite inviting, so Goldie thought she'd try them.
Papa Bear's chair, way too hard.
Mama Bear's chair, way too soft.
Baby Bear's chair, just right. Just right, just right.
Just as Goldie settled in that chair, broke into pieces. Goldie went upstairs and found three nice beds she could sleep in. They looked quite inviting, so Papa's bed she creeped in.
Papa Bear's bed, way too hard.
Mama Bear's bed, way too soft.
Baby Bear's bed, just right, just right, just right.
Goldilocks fell fast asleep. Three bears came back home. Soon as they stepped in, they knew they were not alone.
Someone's been eating my porridge,
growled Papa. Someone's been eating my porridge, said Mama.
Someone's been eating my porridge,
cried Baby.
And they ate it all up, ate it all up.
They walked into the living room, and what do you think they noticed?
Someone's been sitting in my chair,
growled Papa. Someone's been sitting in my chair, said Mama.
Someone's been sitting in my chair,
cried Baby.
And they broken it up, broken it up.
Upstairs in their bedroom now, what do you think they noticed?
Someone's been sleeping in my bed,
growled Papa. Someone's been sleeping in my bed, said Mama.
Someone's been sleeping in my bed,
cried Baby.
And there she is, there she is.
Goldilocks woke up and saw three brown bears staring at her. She screamed,
help!
Jumped out of bed and ran away with the clatter. Down the stairs and through the door, Goldie's gone forevermore. Our three bears, they scratched their heads, fixed the chair and made the beds, and sat down to eat their porridge. And that is the story of the three bears.
Yeah!